हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज शिवानी सिंह फ्रॉम संस्कार ग्लोबल स्कूल. टुडे वी आर हेयर विथ थीम नंबर 9, दैट इज किंग्स एंड क्रॉनिकल्स, द मुगल कोर्ट्स. द टाइम पीरियड इज फ्रॉम 16th सेंचुरी टू 17th सेंचुरी. तो लेट्स सी व्हाट डज द चैप्टर टीचेस अस. इट टीचेस अस अबाउट द क्रॉनिकल्स एंड द वेरियस मेजर इवेंट्स और रिकॉर्ड्स एट द टाइम ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर इन द मुगल कोर्ट. And now we will move towards the topic one, that is the Mughal and their empire. The word Mughal is derived from the word Mongol, and the founder of these empire were the descendants of Zahiruddin Babur. The paternal side of Babur from the side of ruler Timur, and maternal side ruler Genghis Khan, also known as Genghis Khan. And now we will talk about the native place of Babur. He was from Central Asia. The first empire establishment was Kabul, and hometown was known as Fargana. And his son or successor was Humayun. He expanded the empire but lost to leader Sher Shah Suri from Afghan. Humayun died after 1 year by defeating the Suris. His son or successor was Jalaluddin Akbar. He was greatest of all Mughal emperors, made the strongest and unified kingdom. He expanded empire from Hindu Kush mountains to the Central Asia. Akbar had three favorable successors. Akbar, after that Jahangir, then Shah Jahan, then Aurangzeb. After death of Aurangzeb, that was in the year 1707, the power of dynasty diminished. And in 1857, the last section of the dynasty, Bahadur Shah Zafar II, was overthrown by the Britishers. This is how the Mughal Empire finished. Now we will see about the topic 2, the production of chronicles. Chronicles are basically the important source for studying. These were commissioned by the Mughal emperors. There were various titles. The first one was Akbarnama, which included the history of Akbar. Shahnama included the history of Shah Jahan. Nama included the history of Aurangzeb. Mughal emperor translated many of the epics of ancient India like Ramayana and Mahabharata into their Persian language. Mahabharata was translated as Razmanam, the book of wars. Now we will see about the topic 3, the planned and painted image. Now we will see about the paintings. That painting possesses special powers of communicating about the empire. They gave a vivid description of the empire. Painting also enhanced the beauty of the book. Abul Fazl, a historian, describes painting as magical art. Hadith also depicts the image of sitting Prophet Muhammad Sahab. Artists from Iran also made their way to India in the Mughal court. Akbar's court historian was Abu Fazl. Now we will discuss about the ideal kingdom, that is the topic 5, a divine light. According to court chronicles, the power of the Mughal kings came directly from the god. It was assumed like this. Mughal artists began to portray emperors wearing halos like the European paintings of the Christ and Mary. Unifying force. Here we will see that every religion was having equal place in Sulekul. Akbar abolished two types of taxes on religion, tax on pilgrimage and the jizya. And Mughal emperor gave grants to maintain the religious buildings. At the time of Aurangzeb's rulership, the jizya tax was reimposed on the non-Muslim subjects. Emperor should protest four subjects, that is, first one is the life, the honor, the prosperity, the faith. And there were motifs of loin and lamb. They were also very famous symbols between the artists. See about the titles and the gifts. Mughal adopt titles after victory over the enemy. Various titles like Asaf Khan, one of the highest title of minister. Mirza Raja, accorded by Aurangzeb to his two highest nobles. Khilat, robe of honor. Sarapa, head to foot protector. Patka, turban and a sash. And Peshkas, large amount of money. Other things are also included, like ring and weapons were also gifted. Now we will discuss about the emperor household, Mughal. Emperor wives were there, their relations were there, and distant relatives were also there. Mother and rulers were also there, step and foreign mothers, children, sisters, brothers, aunts, daughter-in-laws. Beyond the frontiers, chronicles depicts many titles like Shahenshah, King of Kings, Jahangir, World Caesar, means capturer, Shah Jahan, King of the World. Now we will discuss about the The next topic is the Safavids and the Kandahars. The Kandahars was a bone of contention between the Safavids and Mughals. Humayun's kingdom lost to Sher Shah Sur or Suri, but Akbar reconquered it in 1595. The ill-prepared Mughal garrison was defeated and had to surrender the fortress and the city to the Safavids. Now we will see about the questioning formal religion. Topic 10 is there. Akbar had a great respect to the numbers of the Jesuit mission. Akbar's quest for the religious learning led to interfaith discussion in the Ibadat Khana at Fatehpur Sikri. Akbar interrogated, that means questioned, the scholars of various religions and collected the knowledge about their principles. Akbar and Abul Fazl generated a philosophy of light and used it to shape the image of the king and the ideology of the state. So, summing up the chapter, we can say that the dynasty of the Mughal Empire considered themselves as the genuine rulers of a very large and diverse population. Whether this vast vision was defined by actual political conditions and remained important or not, in the way of transmitting the fanciful view by writing the dynastic histories, the Mughal rulers appointed court historians like Abu Fazl, as we have seen in the chapter, to write the details of their accomplishment, their achievements, their victories. These detailed tasks recorded the events of the ruler's time. Further, the writers collected the great quantity of information from the areas of the subcontinent and also helped the rulers to govern the kingdom well. We can also say that modern historians' work in English got the term genre of the facts as chronicles. The chronicles provide the information about Mughal Empire, as we have seen, and they were the warehouses of the factual information about the institutions of the Mughal Empire also. They were collected and categorized by individuals who are associated with the court, and the texts were designed as conveyors of meanings that the Mughal rulers sought to implement on their kingdom. They provide us a brief view about how the imperial ideas were created and spread. Through this chapter, we have looked about the workings of the rich and charming dimensions of the Mughal Empire. Thank you.